Children's rights are guaranteed by Article 28 of the 1992 Constitution and other legislations, including the Children's Act 1998, Act 560. A violation of these rights constitutes a violation of a child's human rights. In Ghana, violence against children manifests in various forms, including physical, emotional, sexual abuse, and neglect. These could further manifest in cases of child marriage, cyber violence, female genital mutilation, child labor, and child trafficking.
Now, my name is Mama, my name is Papa, and I was a friend, and we are friends at San Rizzo. Now, I do know me, and I know me, I know me, I school. School dine, I am here, I want them like yes, as for no. I am a young man. Na me ti ho no me se me ka ba bi ya na me dan popura na enye se apatafo no mo pom ansane yesu ya pa kwase yekete ni ada boys na wo ho kunya ba fufuru se ya wo ya kula wo ya pemie ombe so mo fefu ombe bu ansane o mo ni wada me mi wo ho no se nkwa fu be ble bu me asu su no minye obi a shi se ni a e ho no ma ho me ti e wo ho no nti no e ma mo fa boy. I'm not going to be able to do this. I'm not going to be able to do this.
We all know that our law says a child is somebody under 18 years. But we on the field found girls who are between the ages of 12 to 18 years who are also into sex working.
Research has shown that physical violence against children is often perpetrated under the guise of discipline and occurs in schools, homes, and in the community. With respect to emotional violence, abuse, and neglect, the 2011 MICS reveals that nearly 9 out of 10 children, representing 89%, have experienced some form of psychological aggression.
Violence against children is a very serious issue that the government of Ghana has put in place institutional arrangements, then a solid legal and policy framework to address. So as early as 1998, the Parliament of Ghana passed the Children's Act, and this provided a comprehensive legal framework, defined who a child is, even had a whole section on child labor, when a child can work, and then what constitutes crimes against children. Then we had strengthening of an institutional arrangement. So we have the Department for Children. The main mandate of the Department for Children, that is a department under the Ministry of Gender, Children and Social Protection, is to coordinate programs related to children across sectors. So across health, across justice, across education, and really focus on early childhood development. We have decentralized this department, so there's a physical presence of this department in the various regions. We have regional directors. Then the policy framework, the Family and Child Welfare Policy, that was launched last year. That is groundbreaking, and that makes the child the center of the policy and has a section on how to address child abuse, physical abuse, mental abuse, sexual abuse, and exploitation of children.
The Department of Children is now engaged in dissemination of the policy in all the regions. So far, as I speak now, 8 regions have been covered. So we have two regions more to cover before the end of, before the middle of June. So we are sensitizing people, engaging children, faith-based organizations. We have also engaged with chief executives so that people will know what constitutes abuse.
UNICEF has been working with the government of Ghana over the past several years in creating a strong child protection system. And it's a complex system that comprises of many different pieces and many different processes. But in short, we can say that we have supported and we continue to support the government in advancing its policy and regulatory legal framework for better protection for children. For UNICEF, we recognize that parents have a very critical role to play in always keeping their children safe, in making sure that they are well, and that the risks that they may face in life growing up are well understood by them. But also, of course, as parents, we have responsibility to making sure that children also enjoy the opportunities that life is presenting to them. I think these new emerging issues, such as online issues, what happens online and on the internet, it is certainly a new issue where parents may have difficulties catching up. As a mother, I certainly cannot keep up with technology as quickly as my children can, but I can ask them questions. What is it that you're watching? What is it that you're seeing? And I can make sure that they are empowered enough and that they understand the risks and the opportunities that the new environment is presenting to for them.
So in looking at the future, we want a Ghana where the child living in Ghana is safe and will not be subjected to abuse. Be it physical, be it mental, be it psychological, that the child grows up in a safe space and is able to develop his or her full potential.
Collectively addressing violence, abuse, and exploitation of children is a responsibility that rests with everyone. Let's work together to make it happen.
Addressing these emerging child protection issues is crucial for the development of a robust national child protection system.